Flashback all the way to 2001. Bigwigs from the OG Xbox era compete for charity in this installment of You've Got Game Show Xbox Edition. I'm Jessica Chobot, licensed professional trivia antagonizer extraordinaire, and these are my accomplices on this very sentimental throwback episode of You've Got Game Show Xbox Edition. With us today are Seamus Blackley, co-creator of the original Xbox, or also known by his legendary status of Yeast Master. What is that all about, Seamus?
I think we've all done things online we regret.
I'm very familiar with that, actually, Seamus. All right, moving on. Ed Fries, who was the vice president of Microsoft Game Studios for the original Xbox and responsible for bringing some of the most unique game and epic franchises to the platform. Out of those epic franchises, which one would you say is your favorite?
Psychonauts, just to be, you know, which we didn't even end up shipping, but started in our group.
And we also have Tom Russo, who revealed the Xbox to the world via a cover story in Next Gen magazine when you were the editor-in-chief. Tom, tell me, because I'm having some trouble. What is this? What is a magazine?
Yeah, it was the form of communication used by the ancient Egyptians in which they wrote down information on papyrus and then shipped it around the country for people who were playing games already electronically online.
Right. That's fascinating.
I thought you were going to say bread.
I thought that's what we were going to get out of Yeastmaster.
Yeah, wrote it on bread, yeah.
Like I said, you know, some things you mistakenly type into your phone and then you live with them for the rest of your life. Careful out there, kids.
All right, so just a quick rundown on the rules. They're very simple. Obviously, there are three of you and you'll be competing for two rounds of rapid fire trivia and then a finale that's going to require possibly a little squinting because it's visually based. The points you accrue are a form of cryptocurrency that, at the end of all of this, will be converted into cold hard cash for charitable organizations of your choice. First place will receive $3,000, and then second and third place will receive $1,000 each. So with that being said, let's take a quick look at the charities that you personally selected. All right, so via a complex Microsoft Excel formula, it has been determined that Seamus will choose the category for round one. So Seamus, here are our options. We've got Memecraft, gaming memes that have crept up in the era of social media. You had me at Halo. This is an Xbox-themed game show. Of course we're going to ask you about Halo. Keep it PC, please. This could be anything operating with a keyboard, mouse, or on Windows. And what's in the Xbox? For you hardware nerds, this one is all about tech specs. So with that being said, which will you choose?
Well, I think that just for no other reason than despite Tom Russo, the only non-engineer in this, we're going to have to go with what's inside the Xbox.
Woo, okay.
Get the pain over early.
Okay, so just like I said, rapid fire trivia. There's going to be six questions. You guys ready? This ominously named hardware error was bad news for Xbox 360 owners. Tom.
What is the red ring of death?
That is correct.
Wait, before we go, the Xbox 360 that I bought at Palmdale at the launch event, at Zero Hour launch event, still works. Still sitting right there in my cabinet.
Really?
That's because Tom doesn't actually play games on it.
No, I probably spent 500 hours of Oblivion in that
game. I keep mine in the oven. It's fine.
All right, so moving on. True or false, the Xbox 360's faceplate could be removed for customization. Seamus.
True.
True. How fast was the original Xbox's processor? Seamus.
733, baby.
That is correct.
That's so much faster. The only reason I knew is because I read the Wikipedia article 5 minutes ago.
Okay, true or false, the flops in teraflops is an acronym. Tom.
True.
True. True or false, the original Xbox had the ability to rip MP3s from audio CDs to use as custom in-game soundtracks. I'm Ed.
True.
True. How many 3.5 millimeter ports are on the Xbox adaptive controller? A4, B9, or C19? Tom.
19.
Correct.
How many are on this, though? that's what I went in.
Awesome job, guys. Excellent. Those questions were legitimately pretty tough. So Seamus has 50. Tom, you have 75. Ed, you're at 25. I'm sorry, Ed.
At least I'm not shut out. It's okay. Yeah.
That being said, perhaps the last round was just a little too technical. So for round two, we're going to even the playing field a little bit with something that we call Metacritical. The way that Metacritical is going to work is very simple. When I say the title of an Xbox game, write down the Metacritic score that you think that game ranks at and hold it up to your camera. The contestant closest to the actual score will be awarded 50 points. We'll do this four times. Round two begins now. First title, BioShock. Seamus says 95, Tom says 96, and Ed says 91. You're all really close, but Tom gets it with 96, right on the nose. All right, next one up, Sesame Street, Once Upon a Monster.
So many possibilities. All the Sesame Street titles, you know, they're all mixed up in my head.
Let's see, Ed, you've got 68. Tom, you've got 50. Seamus is 38. Ed, you get it. The actual Metacritic score is 79. Prince of Persia, The Sands of Time. Ed says 94. Tom says 87. Seamus, 85. Ed gets it again. It was 92.
That was a great game, and I love it even more now.
And then last question, Halo Reach. Ed, you're giggling. What are you giggling about?
I can't say why. Okay. I don't want to help my competitors.
Oh, got it. All right. Smart. Okay. Smart, smart. All right. Seamus says 87. Tom says 84. Ed says 94. Ed, you're right. It's 91.
That's why I was giggling. I knew I'd win.
Good job, you guys. That was really impressive. Except for Tom. I thought you would do better.
Not going how I planned.
Yeah, seriously, Tom, how did you not dominate that?
He was like any critic. He gave things a lower rating than they deserve.
Oh!
Gave it the next gen rating, the deserved rating.
All right, so your scores currently stand at Seamus, you have 50. Tom, you've got 125. And Ed, you are in the lead with 175 points.
And Ed's whole family is actually sitting in front of him with big screens, like looking up the answers.
They're trying.
And of course you remember the Metacritic scores when they're tied to your bonus.
Moving on to the final round. All right, so this final round isn't actually about trivia at all. It's about an object and whether you can recognize when it's disguised in ever sharpening pixels. We call it Pixel What's It? All right, so first one to buzz in with the right answer gets 200 points. So it's still anybody's game. Are you ready?
Yep.
All right. You guys should all know what this is. Ed.
It's Clippy.
Clippy.
I really didn't think you guys were going to get that. Yeah, it's Clippy from Microsoft Office.
Clippy actually descended from work that my twin sister did at Microsoft. So it was totally unfair situation. Yeah.
Then Clippy went on to work on Gears of War. Clippy B.
Clippy B.
So hey, ladies and gentlemen, Tom. Yes.
Oh my God, I just got it.
Don't encourage him.
I mean, I'm a sucker for puns. I love puns.
You don't know how bad it gets.
All right, well, we do have all your finalized scores. So in third place, we've got Seamus with 50. Second place is Tom with 125. And in first place, coming up from a very slow start, excellent job, Ed, with 375 points. Yay. Congratulations, guys.
For my charity.
Well, congratulations to everybody's charities. With everybody's charities, we'll be walking away with something. Thank you all for joining us. Thank you, contestants, for sharing your sage industry wisdom. I'm Jessica Choba, and we will be seeing you guys next time on You've Got Game Show, Xbox Edition.